I'm a Japanese American. My parents and grandparents were forced out of their homes and into concentration camps in Omachi, Colorado, and Gila River, Arizona. We said never again, but the Trump administration is implementing indefinite detention for families and children at the border. We said never again, but the Supreme Court upheld the Muslim ban. For decades, Japanese Americans have said never again. We testified before the Presidential Commission, we established Day of Remembrance across the country. We did public school curriculum projects to bring our history to American children. We built museums, we did documentaries. We fought for redress to repudiate our incarceration with a grassroots struggle that took over a decade. And we cheered when Fred Korematsu had his conviction thrown out by a district court in 1983. But we knew that the original Supreme Court decision against Fred Korematsu was still on the books. We feared that someone else would try to use the same trumped up national security justification on another group. We saw a glimpse of that in 1979 when people called for the incarceration of Iranian Americans and put them behind barbed wire. We saw a glimpse of hell when the day after September 11, 2001, everybody was saying it's like Pearl Harbor, and the scapegoating on steroids began of Arab Americans and Muslim Americans, as well as anybody who looked like a Muslim. This is when Japanese Americans knew beyond a doubt that we had to do something. We said never again, but it's happening now. Nobody can fool us. The Chief Justice of the Supreme Court can say that it's not happening, but it is. On June 26th, Chief Justice John Roberts said that nobody should ever cite the Korematsu Supreme Court case because it's bad law. But if that's true, he should never have upheld the Muslim ban. In the Korematsu case, the government smeared an entire class of people, persons of Japanese ancestry, citizens and immigrants, using vague claims of national security as the justification. Japanese Americans were considered to be inherently disloyal as a race. And in the Muslim ban, the Trump administration does the exact same thing. We need a Supreme Court that isn't corrupt and that isn't beholden to the executive branch. We need an independent Supreme Court that will defend ordinary people and defend the U.S. Constitution. We said never again, we'll say it again and again, and we'll keep on fighting. No Muslim ban ever.
Well, I think it's really important for Japanese Americans to join an organization. I'm part of a network called Nikkei Resistors, and we're based in the San Francisco and San Jose Bay area. And our goal is to mobilize Japanese Americans. We think that Japanese Americans have not only an obligation, but we have a moral authority to weigh in on these issues of justice and equality because of our history and because of the experiences of our families. So I think it's really, really important that we join together. We have to make our voices as strong as possible, and I think by joining together we can do that.